worshipful. Jesus' body was no longer there, but in its place was a perfectly folded napkin that once was wrapped around his still body. The way that napkin was laid is proof that our master is to come back someday. See, in Hebrew tradition, a folded napkin was a clear message to the servant that the master was not done with his food. So this folded napkin in this empty tomb tells us that our master is not done, and his resurrection is only the beginning. He's not done. He's not done. He's not done. The folded napkin is where our story begins, a story of a risen king coupled with the promise of a continued work in us, a story of resurrected gifts and talents, dreams and desires, mercy and grace, a story that tells of something better to come. The righteous one gives us the Holy Spirit of truth who tells us what is to come. Aren't you glad the napkin is folded? The napkin is folded on the dreams you left behind. The napkin is folded on the hurt in your heart. The napkin is folded on a diagnosis that says no. The napkin is folded on what your finances don't cover. The napkin is folded on the relationship you thought was destroyed. He's not done. He's not done. He's not done. Thank you, Jesus. As Jesus was resurrected, his spirit was given to us. What a great gift. The gift of his constant presence. His spirit is not done dwelling and investing into you. And with his spirit, new things are coming, and your season of now is too. Your season of rest is now. Your season of jubilee is now. Your season of transformation is now. Your season of new is now. Because the napkin is folded. So Jesus, with outstretched arms, we thank you for your thought of us over 2,000 years ago when you folded the napkin. Your resurrection forgives us while loosening the chains of sin. Your resurrection gives us power and authority here on this earth. Your resurrection